Mr. Chief Justice, Senators, and Counsel for the President, this is a defining moment in our history and a challenging time for our nation. A thousand things have gone through my mind since this body voted to not call witnesses in this trial. The vote was unprecedented. The President's former National Security Advisor indicated that he was willing to testify under oath before the Senate, yet this body did not want to hear what he had to say. The President's lawyers have asked you to not believe your lying eyes and ears, to reinterpret the Constitution, and to believe that if the President thinks his reelection is in our national interests, then he can do whatever he wants, anything, to make it happen. And that's exactly what he was attempting to do, anything, when he illegally held much-needed military aid while pressuring Ukraine's president to announce bogus investigations into his most feared political rival. This trial is about abuse of power, obstruction, breaking the law, and our system of checks and balances. And since we are talking about the President of the United States, this trial is also most certainly about character. I'm reminded today, Senators, of my own father. He worked more than one job. He didn't have a famous last name. His name appeared on no buildings. But my father was rich in something no money and apparently no powerful position can buy. You see, my father was a man who was decent, honest, a man of integrity. And he was a man of good moral character. The President's lawyer never spoke about the President's character during this trial, and I find that quite telling. I joined the police department because I wanted to make a difference. And I believe I did. As a police chief, I was always concerned about the message we were sending inside the agency, especially to young recruits, especially to newly hired, dedicated police officers. We had to be careful about just how we were defining what was acceptable and unacceptable behavior inside the department and out in the community. Yes, people make mistakes. Yes, individuals make mistakes, but we had to be clear about the culture inside the organization. And we had to send a strong message that the police department was not a place where corruption could reside, where corruption was normalized, and where corruption was covered up. Today, unfortunately, I believe we are holding young police recruits to a higher standard than we are the leader of the free world. If this body fails to hold this president accountable, you must ask yourselves, what kind of republic will we ultimately have with a president who thinks that he can really, truly do whatever he wants? You will send a terrible message to the nation that one can get away with abuse of power, obstruction, cheating, and spreading false narratives if you simply know the right people. Well, today, Senators, I reject that because we are a nation of laws. Abraham Lincoln, the 16th President of the United States, said this: America will never be destroyed from outside. If we falter and lose our freedoms, it will be because we chose to destroy ourselves. I urge you, senators, to vote to convict and remove this president. Thank you so much for your time.